Hi everyone! This tutorial explains how to run Phoenix RealSpace Refine using the Phoenix GUI. RealSpace Refine is a tool to refine atomic models against maps, such as cryo-EM maps. The aim is to obtain a model that fits the map as well as possible while having a meaningful geometry. To run RealSpace Refine, the following inputs are required: a starting model and a map file. If the model contains novel ligands, restraint definitions need to be supplied as well. For the model, different formats are supported, such as PDB or MMCIF. The latter is especially useful for very large structures. For the map, it is possible to use either CCP4 type map files, which are a three-dimensional grid of voxels with density values, or MTZ files, which contain Fourier coefficients. If map files are used, the resolution is also required. If MTZ files are supplied, the resolution is detected automatically from the map coefficients. Note that the unit cell provided in the model file should match either the box information of the map file or the crystal symmetry information in the MTZ file. The data for this tutorial are available from the example datasets which come with the Phoenix installation. To set up the tutorial data, open the Phoenix GUI and click on New Project. Then, click on Setup Tutorial Data. In the new window, click on the Tutorial Data drop-down menu. Go down to CryoEM and choose the second-to-last dataset, called MemK Double Helical Filament. The README file gives some information about the tutorial. Choose a target directory and then click OK. To run Phoenix RealSpace Refine, open the Phoenix GUI. In the panel on the right-hand side, choose Refinement and then click on RealSpace Refinement, which opens a new window. Go first to the Input-Output tab. For bookkeeping, add a job title. Click Add File and select the file Model PDB. Then add the map. As we use a map file, we have to input the resolution, which is 3.64 for this example dataset. If the output model file should be written in MMCIF format, check the corresponding box. Then go to the Refinement Settings tab, which contains most of the essential options for running RealSpace Refine. The following refinement strategies are enabled by default: Global Minimization, ADPs, and Local Rotomer Fitting. The following options are also activated: Rotomer Restraints, Ramachandran Restraints, and C-beta Deviations Restraints. Note that the latter cannot yet be deactivated in the GUI. Furthermore, the tool will automatically search for NCS, and if present, it will attempt to determine NCS groups and use them to define NCS constraints. The default number of refinement cycles is set to 5, but it can be changed. Set it to 3 for this tutorial to speed up the runtime. Click the Run button on the toolbar to start the refinement. After starting the refinement job, the Run Status tab shows the refinement log file, which is updated while the task is running. When refinement is finished, two new tabs, called Results and Validation, appear. The Results tab contains the list of output files. Click the Open in CUDE button to see the map and the final model. The tab Validation shows validation results. It has several sub-tabs. The Summary sub-tab gives a quick overview of data, model, and model versus data quality. Red and yellow highlighted values indicate warnings and problems, so it is recommended to have a closer look. Note that the table is responsive. For example, if you click on the table row corresponding to Rotomer outliers, the GUI will automatically go to the more detailed Rotomer section of the Molprobity sub-tab. From here, you can center on particular outliers in CUDE by simply clicking on the table rows in the Phoenix GUI. The model to data fit is shown in the tab Model versus Data. It lists overall correlation coefficients and features a plot of the correlation coefficient per residue. The Data tab gives reports on the input data, such as Fourier shell correlation plots. It is important to go through all the criteria of the validation report and to address all problems. If the model was changed, another round of refinement is needed, and this workflow is repeated until the best possible model is obtained. I hope this tutorial was helpful. If you have any questions, contact us at help@phoenix-online.org or tutorials@phoenix-online.org.